Hello, Penn, and welcome to this edition of PNN. I'm Dan Murakowski.
And I'm Eileen Hassan. Let's get to your news and announcements for today, Wednesday, November 14th. Any student interested in taking a stand against the tobacco industry can do so through joining the Art Club. The club meets on Wednesdays in room 260 from 3:30 to 5 p.m. 10 high schools from the surrounding St. Joseph County schools are being invited to create a presence through their anti-tobacco art projects. The work will then be displayed in a high-profile location throughout the community. Come to the Art Club and raise your voice against the tobacco industry. Any male student planning on participating in the men's track team should plan on attending the organizational meeting on Thursday, November 15th from 3:35 to 4:30 in LGIA. If you are involved in a winter sport and cannot attend this meeting, see Coach Robertson in room 140.
And here's Eileen with some news on Whirlpool and the fall play, All I Really Need to Know I Learned in Kindergarten. See you in a bit.
The Penn Drama Department performed the play All I Really Need to Know I Learned in Kindergarten on November 7th and 8th. Cast members from the play talked to us about their performance.
The play is called All I Really Need to Know I Learned in Kindergarten.
It's a show with a bunch of short little plays and monologues put together. They all tie together really nicely and have good lessons and morals.
And it's basically about the transition between your kindergarten years to your adulthood years and how, like, your perspective on life changes.
We act as kindergartners for a part of it, and then we also act as adults throughout the play.
I think the audience will get different things out of this play depending on which age they are. If they're older, they're going to find those scenes that are a little more sentimental and stuff that they can relate to more. They'll find that more appealing. As kids our age, like Penn students, will find the funny stuff more entertaining, as I do.
I think this play has a lot of lessons for all ages, and so I think that whatever age you are, you can get an important life lesson from it.
Congratulations to all of the cast and crew on a wonderful performance. For Alexandria Sadowski and Jenny Riley, I'm Eileen Hassan.
Wednesday, Penn students got together in their Whirlpool innovation teams. They presented their inventions to several Whirlpool representatives. They did this in order to narrow down the competition from 22 teams to 8 with 2 alternates. I spoke with Dan Lockwitz and a couple of the participants to learn more.
Today what we're doing is the 2012 Penn STEM Academy Challenge with Whirlpool. We had 22 teams, 98 kids on 22 teams. We're going to reduce that down to 8. So what we're going to do on November 29th, after this is concluded today, is all 22 teams will have the ability to do an informal presentation, and the final 8 teams will be given a formal presentation that afternoon to Whirlpool executives.
We're presenting for the Whirlpool project. It's something we've been doing for a couple months now. We were told to innovate a product, and now we're going to present what we came up with.
What are you hoping students will get out of this experience?
Okay, remember, it's a real-life exercise. And remember Mr. Sauer last year talking about a kind of an artificial problem and artificial solution. This year, as we did last year, we have a real problem and a real solution. So we think the hands-on approach, the kids are going to learn a lot by talking to folks in the community, interacting with Whirlpool people, and just the exercise of getting together with other teams, other kids on their team, rather, will really build more strength in presentation, analysis, and understanding business and technology.
We're getting a lot of experience working with professional companies and developing ideas for the STEM Academy.
We're learning how to function as a team, I guess, work to achieve a certain goal, and we're learning how to present in front of a critical audience, like pretty hard judges and professional people.
I learned to work with the team a lot better, and it upped my competitiveness a lot more because we're competing with other teams. You know, everyone's trying to get in the top 10 with their product, and you know, you're researching and trying to, it's hard at first because everyone's trying to get a good product so we can get these critical Whirlpool people that actually work there to try to vote for us. And it's, at first it's difficult, but then we stuck together and we came up with a product that really helped and really worked.
Thanks, guys, and good luck on your final presentations.
Thanks, Eileen.
You're welcome.
The Turkey Basketball Tournament, hosted by the Fitness Center, will be held on Thursday, November 15th at 7 p.m. All students are allowed to attend. Admission is free with a canned good, which will be donated to the St. Pius Food Drive. If you have lost any items here at school, make sure you check the Lost and Found located at the Visitor's Booth by Door A. Any items not claimed by the end of November will be given to Goodwill. If you have lost any electronics, all lost electronics are given to Resource Officer Kaser in the IMC.
There has been a change for the girls' basketball game versus Mishawaka. The game is now scheduled for this Saturday, November 17th. Here at Penn in the arena, the JV tip-off will start at 6 p.m. and varsity will follow. Please come out and support the Lady Kingsmen as they take on the Cavemen in their home opener. Here's Lauren with more on the French Cooking Club.
The students enjoy this cook-off a lot. They say, we want to do this twice a year. We want to do this more than once a year. They put a lot into it, and for the most part, it's voluntary. So really, the students who do it are the ones who really, really care about it.
What would you rate your food on a scale of 1 to 10?
12.
The first one right away, the chocolate balls were phenomenal. Great texture, great taste.
Were there any special ingredients that were used to prepare your food?
Love and chocolate.
French students did an outstanding job. I think they presented the food well, they all looked great, and they all tasted great.
We walked in and walked around from table to table to get different tastes. We took samples from each table and then filled out a little scoring rubric. I think first of all taste, and then that was 10 points, and then the other two were 5 points each. And just kind of the overall presentation of it and how it looked and tasted and came together. So there's some really high quality stuff. A lot of it was chocolate. And some years we get a sort of variety of French dishes, but this was quite a bit of chocolate, and it just, by the end, I'm pretty sweetened up right now.
Fortunately, we didn't have anything go awry this year, but in the past, students have brought in things like cookies from Martin's, a baguette from Martin's, French fries, French toast, things that aren't French, but this year we didn't have any of that.
Thanks, Lauren. The Penn Band will be performing their annual Kaleidoscope Concert tonight, November 14th, and tomorrow, November 15th at 7 in the CPA. Tickets are $5 and will be on sale today and tomorrow during lunch.
Please note that Zumba Club has switched to Wednesdays in the Fitness Center instead of Tuesdays. The first Zumba Club meeting will be held today after school. Attention, this announcement is for all Penn boys, freshmen through seniors that have an interest in sports, physical conditioning, competition, or fun. The Penn High School boys lacrosse team is holding an informational meeting for all boys interested in participating on the lacrosse team. This is a mandatory meeting for both new and returning players and their parents. To find out more about Kingsmen boys lacrosse, come to an informational meeting on the 28th of November 2012 at 7 p.m. in room 165. You can contact us at kingsmenlax@aol.com for any questions you may have about the club.
The Theater Shorts cast list will be posted today in the Fine Arts office window by the band lockers. All students who auditioned can reference these lists to see if they have been cast. Congratulations to all students who made a cast.
Freshman mentoring will be taking place this Thursday and Friday. Don't forget to wear your shirts. If you are the president of any organization here at Penn and would like to attend the president's meeting on Wednesday morning, November 14th, during the first block, please email the student council at pennstudentcouncil@gmail.com. And that's all the news we have for you today, Penn High School. If you have an announcement or story you would like aired on PNN, feel free to email us at pennnewsnetwork@gmail.com. Until next time, I'm Dan Murakowski.
And I'm Eileen Hassan.